you always wanted to learn to play tennis, but you've been unsure where to start. Do you learn watching FM or not? I said it now, we need a dominated coach and hope to be like them. Playing tennis can help you build speed, power, and fitness. It's also a great way to spend time with your family or your friends. Learn the layout of the court, the scoring system, and all the playing techniques you need to become a tennis pro. Find a place to play. You can play tennis at your local park or gym or a tennis club. So tonight, the rest fans are the best local court draws. Most sports let you play for free, but you probably need to pay membership fees to play anywhere else. You can practice basic swimming techniques in any close open space, but it's best to spend as much time as possible on actual course. You learn the play out of the course faster and minimize the risk of breaking anything with your racket or ball. Buy tennis supplies. You don't need to buy professional dress tennis supplies right away. But every beginner will need to have a few things to get started. Some gym your tennis clubs provide basic supplies for their member. But if that isn't the case, you need to go shopping. You need a racket with the key for a beginner, or you need to do is just to make sure your hand fits comfortably around the handle. The racket should feel like it's too heavy to move, but it also should feel like it weighs nothing. There are also men and women rackets, but you should try all the time fit over gender. In most cases, by at least 3 tennis balls, they get lost very easily. Buy tennis clothes. Before you buy tennis clothes, ask your gym or club if they have any clothing requirement. If not, any clothes comfortable athletic clothes will be fine. Stricter clothes may require to buy tennis shoes and shirts, and tennis good for women. However, this is not always the case. Tennis shoes are the best to play tennis gym. But if you don't have them, any pair of sneakers will do. Find an opponent. Once you learn the basics, you lead an opponent to practice tennis with. Ask anyone you see playing at your local court if they be interested in helping you learn. If not, try asking friends or family, even searching online for a local tennis associations. Learn about the parts of the court, figuring out the different areas of the tennis court is the first step in learning how to play. Different parts of the court are better for different kinds of plays. So spend some time walking around the court before starting to practice tennis question divided into by reconcile this song and the other which opponent. You can touch the net or hit the ball linger it in game. The parallel line foot that from the net is the baseline. You stand here to make the foot the small line in the middle of the baseline is the central smash. You stand to the left to right of the match you serve. There's the thinner line between the baseline and the net. This is the service line. You aim your serve in the area between the net and the service line. The service area is divided into vertical hash. Perpendicular to the net is divided server into left and right sections. The two lines on this side of the court, perpendicular to the net mat. The boundary of the court, the inner line is for the singles game, and the outer is for doubles. Learn the basics of tennis, coding, one player serves the proper game. For the time the ball is served, One point is available to either player. The point is your one is when the ball goes down the bound. Or is missed by a player. Hits the net. Or is missed by a player. The game ends after one player has scored 4 points with a margin of at least 2 points over the loser. For example, a scorer for the 2 mean that the game is over, but the scorer for the 3 mean that the game must continue. Tennis games begin with 0 points on this side. In tennis, a scorer Pedro is called score your card at the beginning. A fixed point serve for scorer 1, the announcer. Our server will call list 15. For scorer 2, the call list 30. For scorer 3, the call list 40. For scorer 4, our winning score, the call list game. It's the point is awarded to the player who doesn't let the ball hit the next bounce twice or go out the bounce. Each of the actions gains the point, reaching the circle when the player who didn't serve wins the game. Play all the rugby games in chess, tennis is played in chess. You don't just play one game and then go home. Chess consists of at least 6 games. The set doesn't then lead to one player with 6 games. Then has the matching up to win over their opponent. For example, if one player has won 6 games, then the other has won 5. They'll have to complete until the winner has 2 more wins than the loser. If both players win 6 games, this is a tie-breaking game, which is usually called tennis matches, usually consist of 3 or 5 sets. Practice hitting the ball with your racket before you start swimming or playing. Practice tossing the ball in the air and hitting it until you can hit the ball hard a few times in a row. Don't worry too much about accuracy right now. Just get the feel for your racket and the feel for the ball. Learn how to do a forehand stroke. The forehand stroke is played by holding the racket out in your dominant hand, like you shaking hands quickly, then pivot so that you grab the racket behind you and hit the ball downward and upward. This will get best for such a high assault. Try a backhand stroke. The backhand, this one of the easiest stroke to master. Hit the racket with both hands, then hold it down to the side. It should look similar to a baseball player that back when the ball approaches. It is hard that the slide upward downward. This just hits the ball hard. And this is your great way to be sure that your ball will get into the server safety. There is also one-handed backhand just to use your dominant hand directly. But everything else stays the same. This one is a little tougher to manage. Learn how to volley. Volleying is the way to return the low shots. They are to carry the volley. Forehand and backhand. In the forehand volley, you have the racket in your dominant hand. With the back of your hand, facing the baseline, simply leaning low shots, the ball, and hit it. The backhand volley is performed similarly, except the back of your hand faces the net. The motion in a backhand volley is similar to elbowing someone out of the way while crouching. People call to choose your server in tennis. One person starts the first serve of the game. Most players choose by leaving a coin, and in most cases, the person who doesn't serve gets to website đập đầu code to play on. The server keeps serving until the game end. For the next game, the other player will serve. Position yourself in the baseline corner. The game starts with both players on the baseline. The server chooses the corner of the baseline to serve from. And the other player position themselves on the upper back corner. So we do serve from right corner of your side of the court. Your opponent will stand in the far left corner from your point of view. You should be standing facing the upper corner. Keep one foot slightly above the baseline and the other about 45 centimeters. It is a way inside the court. Hold your racket out there, facing the right. The required way to the racket as long as your hand. This will have a handle. This will have a firm in your dominant hand. And hold it down with your arm, mesh tendish. Then have the hand of the racket. It's roughly parallel to your hand. When you are serving, you can hold the racket with both hands. Usually, the dominant hand grip the top of the handle with the other hand that the border. But there's no required position as long as you keep your handle hand on the handle only. Throw the ball into the air with your opposite hand if you're serving. Toss the tennis ball into the air. Choose your racket. It's okay to toss the ball around a few times but down using your racket or to bounce it on the court before beginning your official serve. Get used to the ball and how it handles before you serve. If you want to do a practice toss, don't hit it with your racket. Discard it your fault. We could give your opponent the point. Say practice his final game times. If you are serving, continue holding your racket and waiting. Serve the ball to the server champion. When the ball approaches the head of your racket, strike it hard diagonally to the other player, server champion. Aim to the section of the server champion close to them. The idea is to force the ball to bounce once before they can return the serve. If the ball hits the net on the way to the other side of the court, it's called the left, and you can do the serve over again. If the ball stays on the side of the court, go down the bound, or you miss the server just to get the it's your fault. You can get one do over for the fault, but if you fall twice in one serve, the point is the one is to the opponent, and the game moves on to the next point. Run to the upper back corner and hit the ball back immediately after you serve the ball. Run to the upper side of your baseline. Hit the ball firmly with the face of your racket pointed slightly upward. It's teaching practice to learn how to return the server successfully. So don't worry if you do badly the first few times. If you are serving, continue holding your racket and waiting. Continue until the part this one, the part this one, the awarded one, the ball falls out of place. So keep playing until one of you wins the prize. Points can last anywhere from a few seconds to several minutes. But as a beginner, your point will probably be awarded quickly. But the point is awarded, so got the score and serve again. Until the game miss one, and then again, until the set miss one. Hidden overhead return and overhead return this your source where the other player blocks the ball up high over your head and you aim to slam it down on his side, so it's nearly impossible to return. We didn't tell you so with a very high ball to try this one. It won't work on a normal serve. Hold your racket back behind your head so it's ready your back. When the ball is your mouse over your head, slam it down with the racket over the net just that you would look at the serve. Aim to the opposite side of the court from your opponent. You can also do an overhead serve by performing the same actions while serving. Put top spin on your stroke. Adding top spin on your stroke can help the ball bounce higher and move faster. Don't hit the ball head down to the center of your racket like you usually would. Use your racket to hit the side of the ball. Immediately after you serve the ball, move the racket upward and strike the top of the ball. This makes the ball spinning an upward dog instead of moving. With a straight pass, don't just splash the ball. Slicing the ball allows you to change the direction of the ball. Then just slow it down enough to make it lose enough momentum so that it turns on the opponent goes before they have a chance to get to it. Just slide the ball, hit it from underneath first, then immediately bring the racket forward to the opponent's side. This will slow the ball down as it approaches, making the opponent more likely to miss. Learn to play on different surfaces. There are several different kinds of surfaces. You can play tennis on, and it can affect your playing speed and abilities. Learning to master tennis on multiple surfaces can help you improve your game significantly. Hot surfaces like Gasport and Aquinas are more commonly known as America. They tend to be good for beginners because the surfaces allow for more bounces, but they can be hot on players' choice. Clay surfaces are most common in Europe and Latin America, and they tend to make the game less close, the ball also higher than a clay court. Brush courts are the kind used at Wimbledon. Brush court games tend to be very fast, so the ball bounces less than the player. It's more likely to miss your serve. Reach your opponent's strategy. As you get better at tennis, you learn how to study and use their strategy and preferences against them. This is your key that takes you not the time to develop. So don't worry if you can do it right away. Many players, especially beginners, are most comfortable with one specific choice. If you know that your opponent likes to strike the ball high with her forehand motions, you can learn to serve them low ball that requires backhand motions. Many players either love a hit, playing close to the net, figuring out the different areas of the tennis court. It's the first step in learning how to play. Different parts of the court are better for different kinds of plays. So spend some time working around the court before starting to practice. Get to know your opponent, so every player has their serving style. If your opponent always serves the ball in the same direction or at the same height, make sure you're standing there to return the serve. Study your opponent's mental state. A stressed opponent is a vulnerable opponent. If they are reacting angrily, missing easy shots, or don't seem to be paying attention to the game, you can leverage that into a win by serving a variety of shots to confuse them. Let's play doubles tennis. Doubles tennis has to play on this side in step one. You use the wide coach mentioned, but the rest of the scoring and rules remain the same. The big challenge for doubles tennis beginner is to learn how to interact with the chip best. Ask the tennis playing fans to teach you the best strategies for doubles tennis. There is also a variety called Canadian double in which one team has to play as the only one. It's usually played in situations where the single player is far more advanced than the doubles. There is also one handy backhand Josh. There is also a variety called Canadian double. In which one team has to play a jelly as the hard one fight, they have to keep playing each other with the has to more wish than the loser. Be patient with yourself, faster than the sports people spend their lifetime perfecting their techniques, tools, and strategy. Just continue improving your game over time. Be patient with yourself, faster than the sports people spend a lifetime perfecting their techniques, tools, and strategy. Just continue improving your game over time. Hire a personal coach, trainer who will work with your skill sets and help you develop your shots. Make sure your opponent knows that you're a beginner. Some opponent will even agree to the last game standards temporarily to help you develop your serving and hitting techniques. When you feel confident in your basic skills, find a technique play in your community. You meet people who love the sports as much as you do, and you see how you stack up against the competitions. Play in slicker, you get ballet blast use or lip lock, you're not suitable for playing techniques. Once you learn the basic techniques, just you can learn to lock hidden overhead and hit for less. If your elbow forearm already so after playing techniques, put an eye pack on the sore spot to ease the pain. Avoid playing for the day or so to give the tendon time to recover. Learn to play Double techniques has to play a zone this side in stand up one to use the wide coach mentioned, but the rest of the scoring and rule remain the same. The big challenge for double techniques beginners is to learn how to interpret with the teammate as caught the techniques playing fast to teach you the main strategy for double techniques. There is also a variety called Canadian double, in which one team has to play a jelly at the only once. It's usually played in situations where the single player is far more advanced than the double. There is also a variety called Canadian double, in which one team has to play a jelly at the and the hash one fight, they have to keep link in tell the winner has to more wins than the loser.